10th D class, today we are to continue with the HTML forms chapter, and we are going to study various type of buttons that we can create, the text area, that is the multi-line box and combo box. Okay. I start with HTML tag, followed by the body tag, and I am taking BG color as pink, right? Starting with the form tag, I use the table tag here without border. In the first row, I am having two cells where I am writing user ID and I am creating the text box, input type equal to text, name equal to T1. Okay. And I close the TD tag. Here I close my first row. So I have taken the user ID label and I have taken the text box. When you provide the value text to the type attribute of input tag, it will create the single line text box. In this text box, you can only enter the data related to single line. You cannot enter multiple lines in this text box. Right? In the next row, I am taking password and I am creating the password control over here. Name equal to pass, right? And I'm closing this. Now, today I will tell you one third attribute of input tag. Type attribute, you know, it takes the name of the control that you want to create. The name attribute, you know, it takes the name, it creates the name of the control with which it will be stored in the server. Third attribute is value. Value attribute of input tag specifies the initial value that you can enter in the control when the form will start at the first time. When initially you will start the form, the initial value that is given. Suppose I am giving here EF86. EF86. Now this user ID EF86, it will be visible by default when you will see the browser view. Okay, this user ID will be already visible by default in the text box. You can change it if you want. If you are not changing it, by default EF86 will apply. Okay. Here I close the table tag. I apply one BR here. Now suppose from your computer, you want to upload any file in your form. Suppose you have the scan copy of your Aadhaar card and you want to upload the scan copy of your Aadhaar card in your form. For that, there is another control that is available that is called select file field. First of all, write the data, select the file. Now, input type equal to file. Input type equal to file. Okay. name equal to F1. Now, when you will create this control, choose file button automatically will appear on the screen. When you will click on that button, a window will appear from where you can browse for your desired file and you can upload it on the form. Okay? Am I clear? So again, I apply BR here. Now, as I told you that when you enter the text box, that will allow you to enter single line text. But if you want to enter a paragraph, you want to enter multiple line text. For that, there is a special control available, text area. In order to create multiple line text box, you have to take the tag text area, not the input tag. It takes following attributes: rows, I am taking 10 rows, calls, I am taking 10 columns, and name attribute. I am giving the name T2 and close the text area. And before that, you can write one line here. Enter description here. Okay? Am I clear? So one box will appear, and on the top of the box, it will be written enter description here, and you can enter the multiple line entry, might be paragraph or whatever you want. Okay? Now I tell you how to create the combo box. Okay? So combo box or drop down box or select box actually is a box that contains the list of alternatives from where you select the relevant choice as per your requirement. You can select any one or more than one option from the given box. If you are selecting more than one option, that means that is the list box. That is the list box. Okay? Right? So how to create the drop-down box in HTML? We use select tag. Before that, I write here, choose stream. I use the select tag. Select tag is used in order to create the drop-down or the combo box. Name attribute. I am giving the name S1, right? Then inside it, I will be creating my options. Whatever options you want, that should appear in the drop-down box. Make a list of it. Make a list of all those options. But in order to make that list of options, a special tag is used inside the select tag, and that tag is option tag. That tag is option tag. It takes the attribute value. I am giving the value arts. Then write here arts and close the option tag. Then select it and create as many options as you want. Okay, and make the changes. Like I want here commerce. Here I want medical. Here I want non-medical. Here I want humanities. Here you can take robotics. And here you can take history. Okay. When you are done with your desired options, close the select tag. Close the select tag. Am I clear to all? Am I clear to all up till here? Any doubt, any queries? Now, when you will see the browser view, you will see one option already displayed with arrow at the right. When you will click on that arrow, a drop-down list will appear and you will see all these possible options. And you can select any one relevant option from there. Okay. So this is combo box. Now I tell you how to create buttons. Mainly there are two buttons, submit and reset. Submit button is used to submit the data to the server. When you fill the form, when you fill the relevant data in the form and you click on the submit button, your data, your form gets submitted to the server. Okay, whose URL you have provided already, right? The next button is reset. Reset button is used to set the form again to the default values. Whatever values you have entered, again the form will get refreshed and again the form will be set to the default values so that the next user can fill the form. Okay, am I clear? So these two buttons you can create in two ways. First, by using the input tag. Second, by using button tag. How to create the buttons using input tag? I'm using the center tag. Input type equal to submit. Name equal to sub. Value equal to submit. This is the initial value or initial value given to the button. Submit value will be appearing in the button submit. It will create the button with the name submit. Okay. Then another button I create here. Input type equal to reset, name equal to res, value equal to reset. Okay, here I close the center tag, right? So here I close the form tag. Here I close the body tag. And finally, I close the HTML tag. Right? I save this web page with the name form 10th D.html. Form 2. 10th D.html. Let us see the browser view. So here is the form. Let us see. See. Now, as I told you, see the coding carefully. When I created the text box, the single line text box, I enter the value EF86, the initial value, the default value given to the text box. Now see the browser view. It is already appearing by default. You can change it if you want. But if you don't want to change it, by default, one value EF86 already appears in the text box. Am I clear to all? Up till here, am I clear to everyone? 10th D class. Now here you enter the password. Okay. Now see here, select file. I just enter some BR so that it becomes more clear to you. Okay. All right. Now select the file. This button automatically gets created when you use the file control. I click on this button. The browsing window appears. You can select any desirable file and click on the open button. That file will get uploaded in the form. Now see this multiple line box. You can drag it up to the desired limit. And you can fill the form like any multiple lines you can fill. Okay. So you can enter multiple lines. Right? This is text area. The multi-line text box. This is single line text box. Right? The difference is clear. The single line text box you create with the help of input tag. The multiple line box you create with the text area tag. Okay? Then see this drop down box. One option is appearing here. You click on this arrow. The list appears and you can select any relevant option from here. This is drop down box. Now see here, I enter the password. I fill this box and I choose the non-medical value and I click on the submit and the form gets submitted to the server. If I click on reset, just see carefully what will happen when I will click on the reset button. When I click on the reset button, the form set back to its default value. See, the form gets refreshed and set back to its default value. Okay. The use of reset button is clear to everyone. Now I tell you the list box. What is list box? Combo box, I have told you. This is combo box. Click here on the select tag. Provide the space here and write the attribute size. Write the attribute size. Okay. I am giving the size 4. Now this size attribute means when the browser view will be displayed, you will see a box with the scroll button and 4 options will be visible. If you want to view the other options, you have to scroll through the list.
This is list box. See here. Now four options are visible because you have given the size four, that at a time four values must be visible. Now when you want to see the other values, you have to scroll through it like this. Am I clear? And you can select any value from here. Right? Another concept, if I write here multiple, if I write here multiple, multiple means you can select more than one option from the given options. How? I select arts, I press the control key, I select medical. See carefully. At one time, I am selecting more than one option. At one time, I am selecting more than one option with the help of control key because I have set the attribute multiple. Whenever you will provide the size and the multiple attribute inside the select tag, it will always create list box, not combo box. Okay? And if you want to select multiple options, you can use control key. Right? If you want to select adjacent options, use shift key. If you want to select non-adjacent items, select the control key. Agar adjacent options ko select karna hai, to aap shift key daba ke rakhiye. Agar non-adjacent options ko karna hai, to you can use the control key. Right? Am I clear to everyone? Now another concept, I remove this size and multiple. I write here, not here, I write here, after the medical selected. Whenever you write selected keyword in front of any option, that option get selected by default, and when combo box will appear, the name that will be visible, the option that will be visible will be one in front of which you have given the keyword selected. That means now when the combo box will appear, you will see medical option automatically displayed by default, because you have enabled it as selected. Okay. See here carefully. In the box medical option, which you selected by default, selected initially, is visible in the drop-down box. Clear 10th D class. Tenth D, am I clear? Now, similarly in the password box, if you set minimum length equal to 4 or say 5, minimum length equal to 5 means you cannot enter a password less than 5 characters. 5 characters are minimum. Your password should be minimum of 5 characters. You cannot enter any password which is less than the 5 characters. Okay? Am I clear? And when I say max length and I say value 6, 6 is the maximum length. Your password can be maximum of 6 characters. You cannot go beyond it. You cannot go beyond 6 characters. See careful the password box. I am trying to enter long password, but I am restricted by the browser because I have set the maximum limit of the password as 6. Okay? Am I clear? You can enter the short password, but maximum should not go beyond 6. Clear? If I say min, when you enter min, there is no limit to the maximum characters that you can enroll here. Right? Your password can go as much long as you want. Clear? Now pay attention to this no file chosen. I have not given any separate entry here for the no file chosen. I just give the command input type file. So choose file and no file chosen, they will automatically appear when you will create the file control. So file control means when you want to upload any desirable file from your computer to the form, when you want to send your file to the server via form. Okay, clear? And remember, when you are using the table tag along with the form, do not take the border attribute here. No need. This is just to set up the alignment of the boxes and the label. Clear? Now I am scrolling through the entire code. You go through it carefully. Okay? Carefully go through the entire code. Any doubt, any questions? I will ask questions from you just now. Okay, one more method to create button. Using button tag, button type equal to submit. Okay. Name equal to S2. Submit and close the button tag. Input tag is not closed, but you can close the button tag. Button type equal to submit, name equal to the name of the button control, whatever name you want to give, you can give. Then write submit, the name that you want to give to your button, write it over here and close the button tag. See, the button tag get, the button submit get created. Okay, so your buttons can be created in two ways, either by input tag or either by using button tag, right? Am I clear to all? Further, you can make any changes you want. Like I can give style, color, colon, red. See, user ID coming in red color. Similarly, you can set here password, style, okay. The password coming in green color. Am I clear to all? Then select the file. Like you are using H3 over here. Color blue. And you can close the H3 over here. Am I clear to all?